Jordan. Or die! Jordan Love Stinks. Score at Arrowhead Stadium. Your Kansas City Chiefs, 13. The Green Bay Packers, 7. Where the Green Bay Packers had Jordan Love make his National Football League debut. I think it's safe to say Jordan Love stinks. He tried. He got out there and he slung it around. Did the best he could under those circumstances. But when you're dealing with 78,000 fans at Arrowhead and about 8,000 Packers fans, it's tough. It's tough. But Jordan Love had 5 days to prepare for this game. And the Chiefs had a short week coming off a Monday night victory to prepare for this game. Am I giving both teams an out because of those circumstances? Nope. It's what you get when the 7-1 Green Bay Packers invade Arrowhead Stadium to play the 4-4 Kansas City Chiefs. The Chiefs won the toss. They deferred. Packers went 3-and-out. Chiefs had a long 15-play drive, 8 minutes, 3rd-and-goal from the 1. I formation, Patrick Mahomes under center. Gets the snap from Creed Humphrey's big booty. Play action to Darrell Williams. Tosses to Kelsey. Kelsey goes way up. You see their heads behind me. Great play. Your Kansas City Chiefs go up 7-0. Then the Packers have a nice marching drive down the field, and then they miss a 40-yarder. Then the Chiefs start to struggle. Then the punt. Then the Packers go down the field and try a 37-yarder blocked by Alex Okafor. So that 7-0 lead stood for quite a bit. The Chiefs ended up going down the field and kicking up. Chiefs ended up going down the field right before halftime. And on 3rd-and-goal at the 5, Patrick Mahomes threw it underneath to Darrell Williams. Darrell Williams got all the way to the 1-yard line, was nailed. So now it's 4th-and-goal at the 1. And there was a false start. So the Chiefs are backed up and took the field and went up 10-0. And from that moment on, you could sense, you could really sense the Chiefs' frustration that has been going on for the last, 4 weeks. There is a problem. you keep thinking, okay, they're going to snap out of it this week. They're playing the Titans. You're going to see how big this game is. You're going to see this offense is struggling against the Titans. You're going to see them snap out of it. Didn't snap out of it that day. Then you're like, well, we're going to play the terrible New York Giants. They're even worse than the Washington football team and Philadelphia Eagles. They're the worst team in the NFC East. We're definitely going to snap out of it that game. Didn't really snap out of it that game. Well, the Chiefs are playing Jordan Love and the Green Bay Packers. We're going to force a lot of punts. The offense is definitely going to snap out of it that game. Well, they probably could have snapped out of it in the second half. But Travis Kelce dropped a pass on 3rd and 3 that would win him a first down. Then the very next series on 3rd and 2 at the midfield, basically this is probably the same spot that Travis Kelce dropped his. Mecole Hardman dropped his. There is a serious issue going on with the Chiefs offense that Andy Reid needs to address. This is Andy Reid's forte. It's all Andy Reid pays attention to is the offense. When the defense is on the field, Andy Reid goes and sits his ass down on the freaking bench with Mike Kafka and Eric Bieniemy and Patrick Mahomes. They all sit and talk with their clipboards and look and talk to each other about the next series, the last series, what they can do to have a spark. And thank God they had enough spark to win today's game. With the game on the line, 3rd and 10, the Chiefs all need is a first down to ice the game. Patrick Mahomes makes his best play of the game, and I felt confident in him making that play. Even when he was rolling out, I said, do it, Patrick. Here's where you're going to do it. Stepped up or rolled completely out and hit Tyreek. Tyreek Hill ain't dropping anything, at least not today. Tyreek Hill did have a couple of bad passes that he dropped for interceptions. I'm not saying that he's perfect in this season. But for the last couple of weeks, Tyreek Hill's been pretty dependable. And he made a great catch. So your Chiefs are 5-4, a half a game behind the Las Vegas Raiders and the Los Angeles Chargers. There are still 8 games left in the season. This is a 17-game season. The Chiefs are 5-4. Next week, prime time in Vegas against the Las Vegas Raiders. Chiefs or Die are doing it up out there in Vegas. Make sure you check them out on Facebook if you want to get to them with their party. They got a master hotel. They got it all set up if you want to get with them. But for the most part, for the Chiefs, they got to play better offensively. Derek Gore, you know, he had some good carries. Daryl Williams had some good carries, but mostly Daryl Williams was stuffed. Let's look at these stats for your winning Kansas City Chiefs and see who did what and why, buddy. Who did what and why? Okay, Patrick Mahomes was 20 of 37 for 166 yards, 1 touchdown, no interceptions. Pretty pedestrian, but a win's a win. Daryl Williams had 19 carries for 70 yards. Derek Gore had 3 for 13. Tyreek Hill had 1 for -4. Travis Kelce was the Chiefs' leading receiver with 5 catches for 68 yards and a touchdown. Tyreek Hill was 4 for 37. Jerick McKinnon was 3 for 36. Baby cheetah Mecole Hardman was 3 for 20. Daryl Williams was 3 for 7, and Gore was 1 for 6. DeMarcus Robinson, 1 for 2. Josh Gordon still isn't catching anything. He was thrown to once. Looked like a defender got his hand in it. But you don't apologize for wins like this, folks. This brought back memories of the Chiefs in the 1990s when Marty Schottenheimer was a head coach and the Chiefs defense was carrying us. So this game ball goes to the Chiefs defense. Goes to the Chiefs defense. Let's look at these sacks. Who got the sacks for the Chiefs D today, buddy? Let's look at these sacks for the D. Sacks, Tyrann Mathieu had a sack on a blitz. Legarius Sneed had a big interception that cannot be dismissed. The Packers were trying to get within one score. It was 13-0, and it was 9 minutes left. He made that beautiful interception that killed the Packers' momentum. Mike, let me see a sacks-wise. Well, man, Tyrann Mathieu had the only sack. I know Frank Clark was, I know they were in his face, Jordan Love's face most of the night, and Spagnuolo wasn't holding back with the blitzes. I'd like to see more of that against other quarterbacks. Everybody thinks, well, you can't do that against Aaron Rodgers. You can't do that with a veteran quarterback, or he's going to see the one-on-one coverage on the outside. Screw it, man. If it causes the quarterback to rush or get rid of have to throw the ball sooner than he has to, freaking blitz the crap out of him, man. You live by the sword, you die by the sword, and I want to live. Freaking sling that sword like a son of a bitch. Come on. Now, folks, some may say, well, it would have been a different game if Aaron Rodgers would have played. Aaron Rodgers couldn't play. He made up that decision himself when he tried to get some homeopathic remedy for COVID, which you can't do. I'm not one to tell anybody to get a jab or a vaccine or what they want to do because that's their decision. People aren't tuning into the Shaggyshane show to hear what you should and shouldn't do in that situation. But Aaron Rodgers, you took a big gamble and you screwed your team. Aaron Rodgers, a lot of other NFL teams are going to look and see how Aaron Rodgers responds to this situation when he becomes a free agent at the end of this year. Are they going to be like, man, do I want to take a chance on this guy who's doesn't want to get vaccinated? He complains wholeheartedly about having to get vaccinated. He complains about the protocols that he has to go through. And if there's a chance that he gets pulled, do I want to take a chance on that? So Aaron Rodgers hurt himself more than anything. I understand he could say, well, I still want to do my homework. I still want to do this and that. There's enough information out there for Aaron Rodgers to take to see how he wants to prepare himself and what works and what doesn't. But again, I'm not going to tell anybody what to do in that scenario because it's turned into a big political freaking mess, and it's not. It's simple. It's either you do it or you don't, and if you don't, you mask up. If you don't do it, you mask up and you protect yourself. You don't get out there and freaking try to use some remedy that's obviously didn't work because he tested positive, you know. And again, I don't tell people what to do. You're not going to hear Shaggyshane tell anybody what to do in that situation, whether it's politics, vaccine, or whatever, because I got Republican friends, Democrat friends, Christian friends, atheist friends. I got friends who even listen to Michael Jackson. Yes, they listen to Michael Jackson, even though they know beyond a shadow of a doubt that Michael Jackson is a Jehovah's Witness. Now, with that being said, folks, your Kansas City Chiefs are going to be heading to Las Vegas next Sunday to play the Las Vegas Raiders in prime time. Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to want the Chiefs to wake up on the offense. Come on, Andy Reid. Come on, Patrick. Throw a freaking slant. Is it too much trouble to get the freaking snap? I would like to see one slant pass to a wide receiver. Just have Patrick hit Gordon on a quick 8-yard slant. Hike. Patrick gets the ball. Looks. Quick slant. Does that play even exist in this Andy Reid offense? It sure could light a spark. Kelsey. Don't drop those balls, baby cheetah. Don't drop those balls. But you don't apologize for wins. This game ball goes to the defense, as I said. Be proud of this game. Be proud of this win. Be proud of your Chiefs. Because the Kansas City Chiefs are now only a half game back of the division. This division is still up for the grabs. The Raiders and the Chargers aren't running away with it. The Chiefs have the talent in their locker room to do this. They do. Arrowhead Stadium is 4 miles from my house, which you know is only a short drive to the countryside. Where you going? You can't run and hide. So many questions. Questions like, damn, man. Would the offense wake up? Could the offense please just run a slant to Gordon, maybe? We don't need OBJ, son of a gun. We don't need that drama. We need this offense. This offense is built. That locker room is built with champions. Coaching staff on down. Patrick Mahomes on down. Chris Jones on down. Pick up the slack, Jack. You guys are freaking champions. Look at yourself in the mirror and say, we got to do better because there is 8 games left to freaking take charge. Reach deep. Reach deep and stop fucking around with these pussies. Put these guys away. It's in you. It is in you. Dig deep. Until next week, this is Shaggy Shane telling the Chiefs to figure it out because they got the locker room. Until then, go Chiefs.